Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Tita Boy.
Welcome to the program.
It's good to be back here.
And welcome again to my heart.
Oh, I never left, Tita Boy.
Never. You never left. You never left me. And, okay, you know, some people would say, ang tagal namin hindi nakita si Coleen Garcia. Mm-hmm. Almost a year and a half or 2 years. Meron pang ganun, ha? Length of time.
Yeah, yeah.
So tell us a story. What has been happening? Where were you?
Actually, I haven't been active because my last film was before I got married pa. I think that was the last time I was here for Sin Island. Yeah. So that was engaged pa lang kami noon ni Billy. And after that, everything kind of slowed down. I took my time. I took a breather for a while. It's just for the past few years. And you know how it's 2020 and everyone was looking back at the past decade and everything.
Right.
And I just realized that 10 years ago, I was just about to graduate high school. And so much has changed since then. I left my parents' house. I never thought I would be in showbiz. Like 10 years ago, it never crossed my mind. And just, you know, entering here, going through so many things in my showbiz journey, that time that I was so heavily bashed and everything. And I just never really had time to just, you know, find myself again in the middle of all
of that. So if you were doing movies and not much of television,
yeah.
Anong ginagawa mo?
What now?
I mean, in the last 2 years.
Oh, the last 2 years, I did a lot of traveling. That's why it was also so hard to commit. When I was younger, I never traveled with my family. The first time I went out of the country was when I was 13. It was one trip and naulit na like when I left my parents' house na again. So I really didn't get to travel.
So after the wedding, you took advantage of the time
to
be with family.
Yes, it's one of my dreams to really see the world. And I'm glad kasi yung traveling, hindi basta-basta na traveling because a lot of them are opportunities as well. So from different jobs to fashion week and everything, you know, I really got to experience so many things. And I feel like a whole different person now that I got to experience so much, not just here, but outside of our comfort zone, outside of our country. And I got to meet so many people that that got to teach me a lot of things also that I didn't know. So it's kind of...
You didn't miss the movies. You didn't miss...
I missed the movies.
You did.
I realized, because I needed also to stop, because... the entire time I've been here in showbiz, and people know this about me, is that I've always had a bit of, like, reluctance.
Meron.
Yeah. Mm-mm. So, and
I
even...
would agree.
Even like Star Magic and Miss Marioli would tell me, you know, they just sensed that in me, that I was so reluctant and I wasn't sure if I wanted to be here and
so
if
that
I wanted
is true.
To do this.
You're validating that.
Yeah, back then, yes. It was true. It was true. I wasn't sure because I never thought I would have the backbone for this. I never thought that... Kasi hindi ko naman pangarap noon na to sing, to dance, to act, or anything. I was always so shy. And
what,
you know,
did you want to be?
I wanted... Actually, I wanted to either study law. Because my family is into politics.
Right.
But then I realized that I don't want that path. So there were so many things. I was taking a double degree in business. So that's where I was when I started getting all of the opportunities and everything. So, you know, I had a completely different path. And then I was just redirected. And to a path that I had no idea about. And it's
and
something
you started
that,
to like.
Yeah, it's something, but it's something at that time that I wasn't sure if I wanted. I wasn't sure if I belonged here. And I just always felt like I don't know, like I wasn't sure.
So fast forward after 2 years of absence, has that changed?
Yes, definitely. Definitely. It took time away for me to realize that I miss actually more than anything film talaga.
And that brings us to the film that you have. It's called Mia.
Yes.
Tell us about it.
Well, Mia, it's actually the lightest project I have ever done in terms of film.
This is
actually
the lightest.
Lightest, yeah. It is the lightest though. Because, okay. I mean, I was telling them then because it's a press con, it's the first movie na pwedeng panoorin ng mga bata. Excited talaga ako.
Thank you for saying that. I wanted to say it. Finally. Okay. And that makes Crawford happy also.
Yeah.
Okay, Mia is a bio doctor.
Yeah, she is a doctor.
Okay.
And then she goes through something. Actually, so opening scene palang, you're gonna see what that is. But it's something
we can't
that...
talk about it yet.
Not yet.
Okay.
But it's a first scene. So and then from that, she just actually. Tito Boy, it's so familiar then sa pinagdaanan ko because she tries to find hope and she tries to pick up the pieces and she tries to put it all together again and to just stand on her own. So it's something that at that time I was really able to relate to.
But it's really interesting because you're a doctor, you're supposed to be in the business of healing
yes,
others.
You're supposed to be put together diba? And everything.
Tapos ikaw ang dami mong pinagdadaanan.
Yes.
And then the character of EA comes along. Edgar Allan Guzman, we're talking about Edgar Allan, and then this whole story unfolds.
Yes, yes. It's good because he tries to give her hope, but it can't come from another person. So he's trying to help her find that within herself.
I wanted to ask you this, Colleen, both as an actor at bilang isang babae.
Yes.
What can the other do to someone who's going through rough and tough times? Because you know, when somebody says, I'm just here,
yes.
I understand, I feel you, I see you. Yes. Now, when you say, wala ka naman talagang magagawa because if I want to do something, ako lang ang pwede. But
yeah, yeah.
How valuable is that other person who's willing to give you time, love, you know?
It's really, it means the world. Like I told you, Tito Boy, it's strange kasi, you know how normally, like, you go through, like, what I went through the past 2 years, you normally go through that before marriage. Like, you try to find yourself, you try to realize, you know, you try to find what you want to do and who you want to become and everything. And they always said you have to do that before you get married. But for me, in my case, it was such a big help to be with Billy because he was able to guide me, you know, being somebody who's older, more mature, older talaga. Hindi lang yon, pero syempre more mature.
You know, deliberately, I didn't look at him. Okay, so baligtad, you
pero,
know,
yeah,
he
you
was
know,
there to guide you.
Yes, because, you know, there were so many times in the past 2 years that I really felt like I was losing myself. And sometimes you just need somebody who really knows you and who appreciates everything you are, who doesn't want to change anything about who you are, to just remind you who you
do
are.
Do you like that person to be like the character of Edgar Allan? Yung,
yeah.
yung taong yun, gusto mong nagsasalita? Gusto mong nakakarinig ng salita? Or are you the type of girl who just wants him to be there? It's enough that you know that he is present.
For me, kasi I always try to look for, you know, the words that will make me feel better, but it's hard. Eh? I mean, you can't just heal with words, and whatever words you find, it's just hard. The pain will always be there. So it's a matter of rising above it. It's a matter of overcoming it. And you
so
know,
mas gusto like, mo yung presence.
Mas gusto ko talaga yung presence.
Gusto mo yung tahimik. Gusto mo yung binibigyan ka ng espasyo.
Yes.
That's
but also, one thing I realized, it's important to make people feel that their struggles are valid and that their whatever thoughts, whatever they think about themselves. Because, like, for example, with me and Billy, like, ang dami kong insecurities. And I would tell him, love, I feel like this, I feel like that. And he said, but love, you're not like that. And that's the thing, like, you know, okay, I'm not, but this is what I believe about myself. And I want to change that. So I want to, you know, but...
How do you do that?
For me, you really, you know, it's something that no matter who helps you around you, it's something you really have to find within yourself.
And it takes time.
It really does. But you have to know yourself. And you know what, honestly, Tito Boy, ha? Walang etos, walang ano man. But one piece of advice that stood out for me also that helped me during this time was from you. And it was during the time na nag-hosting ano workshop kami with you with Sinasian pa at that time. And you told me it's important to always go back to your core. And that's what I did. So, you know, I spent so much time the past 2 years seeing the world, being with my family, and just being myself again. And it's been a while because I just felt like I was never enough and I felt like there was always something wrong. I felt like, you know, so...
Thank you for sharing this story. I mean, diba? And again, I will say this. Kahit anong pagdaanan mo, stay true to your core. Stay true to your truth. dahil you will survive anything with your truth. Pero ang gusto ko lang sabihin, because I've worked with Billy, I've sat beside him for a number of months.
Yes.
He adores you.
The feeling is yun. Mutual.
No, but he
otherwise,
does.
He wouldn't be married.
Mahal na mahal ka ng asawa
mo. Yeah, I'm really blessed.
Yeah, mahal na mahal. And you know, and it's not even, hindi dahil sa sinasabi niya, but you know, every time we talk about it, because I'd say hello, you know, there's something there. May nuance na alam mong mahal na mahal ka ng asawa mo.
And I always tell him I'm so grateful that he honors me even when I'm not around.
He does. He really does.
It's so
really
important. Does.
Pag New Year daw kasi emosyonal.
Yeah,
lalo
reflective.
Lalo nang nandito tong comfort nito, dapat hindi ito dumating eh. No, but he does. He has, and I love that word. He really does. He honors you. Oo, he honors you. And maraming tao magsasabing, si Colleen talks about not being enough. Pinagdaanan niya yung mga panahon na, do I matter? Sa ganda niyang yan? Do you get that? And sometimes I don't understand that,
yeah.
Na walang kinalaman ito.
Wala talaga, oh, Tito Boy. Kahit ano pang itsura mo, it doesn't matter. Eh. When I look at myself, well, at least during that time, when I would look at myself in the mirror, I wouldn't see what everybody would see in me.
That's true.
I'd see something different. Yung tipong, ang naaalala ko pag nakakakita ko ng picture sa akin, yung pinaka-pinaka-pangit ko. Mm-hmm. And that's what stays in my head. And whatever it is, like, It grew to a point where I was such a perfectionist, and it's hard to be perfectionist and feel like you're not enough, because then, you know, you're never gonna feel like you're enough. So you're just gonna always burn out and
right.
Put everything out, and nothing's gonna be coming.
But
back.
It's so nice to talk about it because yeah. Your journey towards.
Yeah,
it.
And it's I feel like I've really overcome that, and I've passed that stage. It was a season in my life.
Ganda. Yeah. You know, and it's also good that you have a partner, you have a husband who makes you feel. Worthy.
Yes, yes.
Who makes you feel that you matter.
Yeah, because if you're gonna choose to be with somebody every day, it has to be somebody who lifts you up. Yeah.
That's right. Okay. And because we're talking about Mia, and we should be watching this movie, kailan ipapalabas ang pelikula?
Ipapalabas siya actually sa January 15 na.
Okay.
So, malapit na. And we actually have something on the 13th. It's called National Mia Day. And it's cool because it's the first time I've done something like this. Because it's actually my first movie din na yung title role. So,
congratulations.
Thank you.
What a way to start 2020.
I know, I'm so excited.
Okay.
But actually...
So, 13 is a National Mia Day.
Yes, yes. So,
Abundance, don't forget. It's 13 is a National Mia Day. Day, and what's gonna happen?
What's gonna happen is everybody na may pangalan na Mia is invited to come watch with us for free. That's actually our premiere.
You know, actually,
night
my
na.
Second name is Mia.
Boy Mia.
Boy Mia. Okay, so lahat ng may pangalan na Mia ay pwedeng makapanood ng pelikula na libre.
Yes.
So, pwede bang Mia na palayaw?
Yeah, as long as you can, I guess you can prove it. You know, you have like maybe.
What do you do? I mean, you go to the where do they?
If you can verify, maybe if you have like any form
any
of proof,
identification
like
card.
Whether it's your social media or.
So, saan sila pwedeng manood?
Sa SM Mega Mall sa January 13. That's actually our premiere night, so nandun kami.
So lahat ng Mia po. Ay,
invited, yes.
Ay, that's cool.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Hi, Mia. Lahat, Mia. Sino mga kasama pa dito sa pelikula?
Kasama ko si, of course, Edgar Allan Guzman, and Miss Yayo Aguila, William Martinez. Actually, marami pang iba.
Under Viva Films, and
yes,
this is directed by?
Directed by Veronica Velasco.
Wow.
Yes. So, yeah.
Ito'y pagbabalik ni Veronica.
Yes.
To a certain extent, not because she didn't do a film in a number of months.
Yeah, yeah.
Diba?
I think she. I did watch the one of Alex and Paolo.
Which I think was the last, no?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Hindi naman pagbabalik. Parang inaabangan ko lahat ang pelikula.
She's really good. She was really, really great.
Really, really good. So abangan ho natin yan. That opens January 15. But on January 13 at SM Mega Mall, lahat ho ng Mia ay libreng makapanood ng pelikula Mia.
Yes, yes. And also, actually, we have mga mall shows then.
Go ahead.
We have January 11 at SM Dasmariñas, January 12 at Fisher Mall, Malabon, and Quezon Avenue. So, see you.
Congratulations. I'm really happy for you, Feline.
Thank you. Thank
Sana sunod-sunod ang mga pelikulang darating. Okay. And because we're talking about, you know, an acting piece for Colleen, so subukan natin ang husay mo at ko umarte. Halimbawa lamang, there's a character in the film that's called Bru.
Yes, yan. Bromeliad.
Wow. Si Bromeliad ito.
Si Bromeliad, yes.
Okay. Si Bromeliad, halimbawa, ay best friend. Hindi naman best friend, but kaibigan mo. And then, sabihin natin kapitbahay si Bromeliad, si Bru. Tapos sasabihin mo sa kanya na nangangaliwa ang kanyang boyfriend. Nangangaliwa ang kanyang boyfriend. Nakita mo sa isang mall. You can create your story. You can create, you know, whatever. How would you break the news? How would you break the news that you actually discovered that the boyfriend of Bru has another woman? Paano mo gagawin? Sige nga. Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, action.
Bru, mahirap to ha, pero may kailangan ako sabihin sa'yo. Kasi, okay, andun ako sa mall kahapon. Tapos, nakita ko si Fern. May kasamang ibang bulaklak! Hindi ko alam kung anong gagawin ko, pero nagtago ako. Tapos sinundan ko sila. Tapos, tinitingnan ko kung saan pumupunta, pero papasok sila sa isang sinehan. Ang nakalagay, Nia. Tapos, pumasok ako. Tapos nung pagpasok ko, hinahanap ko sila. Hinahanap ko yung mga... ayoko magmura, ayoko magsabi ng masama, pero hinahanap ko sila, hinahanap ko sila. Hindi ko sila nahanap kasi sobrang ganda ng pelikula, pinanood ko na lang.
Diba? Umiiyak talaga si Bru. Oo, ito naman, next. Ito naman si Bri.
Si Bri!
Oo, si Bri. Best friend. Aamin ka na may gusto ka sa kanya. Kunyari, you know,
okay.
You're the...
Every... Oh, the mug?
Oh, the... Okay. Wow, okay. Okay, best friend. You're 15 years old.
15?
Andito kasi si Crawford. Baka sabihin...
Wala, 18 naman.
18. Okay,
may...
just before the marriage, okay? Best friend mo, tapos may gusto ka sa kanya. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, action!
Bri, gusto ko lang sabihin na yung friendship natin, sobra akong na-appreciate. Pero, may pagtatapat sana ako sa'yo. Kasi, medyo, hindi ko kasi inakala na mahuhulog pala ako sa'yo. Pero, Bri, ayoko sana na masira yung friendship natin. Pero, if you don't feel the same way, then I... I love you too now.
Sabi?
Sabi na.
Oh, last na. Galing-galing ni Colleen, ha? Ito na lang. Ito naman,
oh my gosh!
Si Bru, si Bri, at saka si Bra.
Si Bra! Wala bang si Bro?
Si Bra, kaibigan mo. Mangungutang ka.
Uy! Oh my gosh!
Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, action!
Bra! Nakakahiya, pero wala na akong ibang mapuntahan kasi alam ko naman na, ano, marami kang ipon, ang yaman-yaman mo. Malibre ka naman minsan, no? Pero actually, imbis sa malibre ka, may mas magandang idea ako. Mas magandang idea sa libre. Ano yun? Ano yun? Kailangan ko kasi bumili ng kotse. Alam ko na hindi mo naman ako ililibre, pero okay na yung utang. Okay na yun. Okay na yun. Huwag mo na ako ilibre. Huwag mo na ako ilibre. Utang na lang. Okay na yun. Salamat, ha?
Okay na daw.
Okay na yun. Pwede na yun. Pwede na yun. Salamat, ha? Salamat, bra. I love you.
Maraming maraming salamat. You know, when people say it's easy to be an actor, it's not.
It's not.
It's not. It's not. It's not easy. But thank you for being such a good sport.
Thank you for having me, guys.
Okay, number one, we want to find out, how did you celebrate the New Year's Eve? That's number one, I want to know. Pangalawa, you know, I saw a post of Billy. Yeah. Kung saan kasama niyo. You know, I met him, Mark. Remember? Marcos.
Yeah, Marcos.
Marcos is there. Yeah, and then Mika and JR.
Yes,
Na nanligaw pero hindi naman nung mga kapanahon. Wala, di ba? It was a nice photo. And among the comments, I was telling Billy, among the comments, may nagsabing, si Colleen Garcia kasi maagang nag-asawa, parang hindi siya masaya bilang Mrs. Crawford. I read the reaction of Billy. Ano ang iyong reaksyon sa kanyang reaksyon? Ano ang iyong reaksyon doon sa nag-comment? Ang kasagutan sa pagbabalik po ng TWBA. We're back on the show with Colleen. New Year's Eve. Tell me the story. Nasaan kayo at paano kayo nagdiwang ng pagsalubong ng bagong taon?
Actually, medyo weird. Kasi so sabi ko kay Billy, gusto ko magkasama kami sa ano sa countdown at least, di ba? So I went with him to the countdown. Pero nung mismong
he
countdown,
was at BGC
tama? Yes. Okay. He performed with sina Yang, sina Bamboo, and then he invited Sam also, Sam Concepcion, to come. Pero siya yung nag-invite kay Sam. So nung by that time na ano nag-countdown na, they were all on stage. And then, it was like 30 minutes prior to the countdown. I was just in the tent with Sam. Then Sam was like, are we gonna spend the countdown here? Kaming dalawa lang inside the tent. Di ba lang kami makakanood ng fireworks or anything. So, but it was such a strange scene. So we were like, sige na nga, let's go out. So we went out and then we went to watch them. So we were watching them perform, sina Billy, Yang, and Bamboo. And then, nung countdown na, okay, 10, 9. So we were watching. Bigla nakita namin si Billy. He went to the opposite side of the stage. And he started running because he went back to the tent to look for us. Kami naman ni Sam, we were on the other end, opposite, ang layo. Hindi na kami sumigaw or anything, but so we were just watching him run. So yung buong countdown namin, the whole countdown, pinapanood lang namin na tumatakbo si Billy from everywhere looking for us.
Well, the way to look at it, kasi may magsasabing, hay, maghahanap pang kayo buong taon. Ako, hindi. You're gonna have fun the whole year.
Yeah, true.
That's
we're
the
just
way
gonna
you
laugh. I'm gonna laugh at Billy the whole year.
That's what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go to that post. And that was funny, okay?
Yeah.
An innocent post. Behind was a lovely Christmas tree. Was that your house?
It was JR's house.
Okay.
Yeah.
So may nag-comment that Colleen, Mrs. Crawford yata ang tawag sa'yo. It seems like she's not happy because she married early, etc. Sinagot ng Crawford. Okay?
Of course, yung Crawford na sumasagot.
And talked about the nose. And bakit? Alam mo ba? Anong nangyayari? Nakatira ka po sa bahay namin?
Ay, nako.
Loved it.
Patol kasi ng patol eh. Sabi ko, wag.
Your reaction?
I mean, I'm gonna be completely honest with you, boy. I never saw the comment. Nagulat na lang ako sa press ko nung tinanong sa akin. But, because I mean, I'm with him every day, so I don't stalk him anywhere sa social media.
Right.
But, so hindi siya nakaabot sa akin. But, I mean, when I was asked about
na-enjoy
it, so
ko yun,
I
kasi
heard,
kilala ko si Crawford.
Yeah, true. But I did, I mean, yun nga, siguro it wasn't just the picture. Siguro it was the fact na yun nga, they haven't seen me for the past 2 years, so they can only guess nga na. Siguro she's so unhappy because she's not working or whatever, you know.
But it can be so intrusive.
Assumptions.
It can be so intrusive.
It can. Diba? But it's just a matter of accepting.
But
that
it's territorial. It's territorial.
Ito kasi napipikon. Ako, I just kind of let it slide. But
wala sa'yo.
Ano kasi si Billy, like, when it's him, medyo okay pa eh. Like, he can handle it.
Not but you.
When it's, or even just people he loves, like his parents or anything.
Right.
So he doesn't like it.
He's very loyal.
Yes, very.
Mm. He is very loyal. So, ako naman natawa dahil trademark Crawford.
Yeah. Yep.
So, ano, nagahanap ka ng papatol? Ayan. Okay. Now, lesson there, the lesson I learned from that comment is, sana sa 2020, we become kinder, we become more compassionate, we become more respectful of spaces.
Yeah.
Because we don't know kung ano ang pinagdadaanan ng ating
kapwa.
That's
so true. But, you know, I always tell Billy, even the commenters, you don't know eh. You don't know. Baka, actually, minsan kasi some people just say some, like, really weird things. I mean, you never know kung saan sila nanggagaling.
And because
often
also,
it's from pain as well, right, diba? But you never, but also you never know, baka may sakit yung tao na yun. Or, you know, because I have relatives, like I have a relative who has autism and then he's very active in social media. And sometimes he comes across a bit too strong or he comes across differently to other people and they don't know.
Thank you for saying that.
Yeah, so they tend, you know, if you attack the person, kawawa naman, diba? And you never really know. So if you don't know, it's best to just step back, maybe.
Yeah, but that's kindness.
And just not judge.
That's really kindness.
Yeah, to just maybe understand, a bit of understanding and allowance, maybe,
okay.
Yeah.
All right. I get it.
Yeah.
I totally get it. But that's an entirely different perspective. And I saw it now.
Yeah.
Na maaring ang may pinagdadaanan ay yung nagko-comment.
Yes.
Diba?
Yes.
But that takes a lot.
It does.
Diba? Once again, invite everybody to the National Mia Day and
yes.
to the regular showing of the film.
National Mia Day is this January 13. Even if your name is not Mia, I mean, come say hello. We're going to be
right.
there in SM Mega Mall, Cinema 1, 7 p.m. And of course, Mia will be showing in cinemas nationwide starting January 15. And I really hope you guys give it a chance because it's really such a light film. And I know for a fact that, you know, if you watch the film, you're gonna leave the cinema with a smile on your face.
Ay.
Hindi yung mangyak-nyak or
yan ang maganda.
Mabigat. Or,
masaya.
Yeah, masaya. Hindi siya yung sobrang bigat yung drama or anything. It's just everything's very light.
At supportahan po natin si Colleen. Ito po ang kanyang unang pelikula kung saan lahat
yes.
pwedeng manood.
Yes!
Ang buong pamilya.
Okay, Tito Boy, I'm gonna be honest. Also kasi, I mean, another factor also why I did stop is because I was really waiting for the right project. I wanted to do something different. I wanted something that would be full. I mean, I loved all my past projects, but just for this new chapter in my life, I wanted something that would be a different kind of fulfilling. And just, I actually received a bunch of scripts also that I could have easily accepted, but
yes.
my heart wasn't in it. And I just decided that from now on, if I'm gonna accept a project or a film or something, I really want my heart to be in it because it feels so magical when it is. So, you know, I've waited and it took some time to make this film, but I really feel like it was worth the wait.
I'm sure it's worth it. Always respect and follow that height.
Yes, and God's timing talaga.
Tama.
You know, I honestly feel that God wanted me to rest.
Tama.
I feel like, you know, He saw how messed up I was in my mind already and He's like, you need to chill.
Tama.
I think the past 2 years just really helped me with that.
Minsan hindi mo alam kung bakit nangyayari, no? But again,
it's
enough that He up there knows.
Yes,
okay,
definitely.
Mia, mga kaibigan, is produced by Insight 360 or 360 mm-hmm. Films. Distributed by Viva
yes,
Films.
Yes, yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
We're going to do Fasto.
Okay.
Ah. Okay. We're going to do Fasto. Colleen.
Okay.
What can't you get enough of?
Food.
Complete a statement. 2020 is a year of?
Hope.
What shuts you up?
Pag pinahiya ako.
Sino ang konsyensya mo?
God.
Yes, no. Do you miss being on... It's showtime.
Yes.
One thing better than sex.
ice cream.
Paano ka nangangalabit kay Billy?
Tinanong ko na to sa kanya before. Sabi niya, you don't.
Ako naman, I agree. I know. Kung ulam si Billy, ano siya?
Ulam? Naku. Kaldereta.
Pinakamatigas sa bahagi ng katawan ng asawa mo?
Yung baba. Ay, hindi. Yung ulo. Matigas ang ulo.
That's
sobra.
Right. Kung bibigyan mo ng pangalan ng private part ni Billy, what name would you give
it? Oh my God. Pudutski? Pudutski, pai! Oh my gosh, nag-walk out na siya.
I love you, Crawford. Thank you, Colleen. No. Thank you very much. And I wish you the best.
Thank you. Thank you.
All the love, all the best projects in 2020, and the best life.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And you know, I love you and I love Billy.
I love
and
you too,
God bless you always.
Thank you.
Maraming, maraming salamat. Thank you. And Voice of La Carmela de Boracay, thank you. Jovialin Sangan Moren and Lawrence of Orange Blush. Bart Borja of IMG Move on Clothing. Amaria Theros, Doctor's Man and Pai Kalayan. Maraming maraming salamat. Live and love in abundance and always make Nanay proud. Be kind. Abundance. Good night.